Dear students, welcome again. The lecture will cover the decomposition pathways of transition metal alkyls. As we have already studied that the transition metal alkyls are unstable. They are unstable. So what are the reasons of their instability? What are the pathways that causes their instability? So we will discuss one by one. So number one pathway of decomposition is hydrogen elimination or hydride elimination. So hydride elimination may be alpha, may be beta. So if alpha hydrogen is present, like for example in this reaction we can see that this is the metal center and these are the two ligands. This is metal alkyl complex. So especially transition metal alkyl complexes are very unstable. So in this case, this is alpha carbon and this is alpha hydrogen. So due to presence of this alpha hydrogen, this hydride will eliminate. The hydride present at the alpha position, that will eliminate and form M double bond CH2 and CH4. So it is very unstable and it can form the products like M double bond CH2 and CH4. So this is alpha hydride elimination. And these kind of eliminations occur in the compounds, in the organometallic compounds which have alpha hydrogen. So like metal benzyls C6H5CH2M. So this carbon atom is having an alpha hydrogen. So it can eliminate this hydrogen, can be eliminated as hydride ion from this alpha carbon atom. And the other example is neopentyl complex like this. So it also has this alpha hydrogen. So in case the compound has alpha hydrogen, there may be the chances of elimination of alpha hydride elimination. The most common pathway of alkyl decomposition, transition metal alkyl decomposition, is beta hydride elimination. So in case of organometallic compounds where beta hydrogen is present, so this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon, so this is beta hydrogen. So when this hydrogen is present, this hydrogen can be eliminated in the form of hydride. So this kind of hydride alkene complex is an intermediate complex, and you can see that the coordination number of this metal increases during intermediate position. So during intermediate states, its coordination number increases and this become very unstable, and then formation of MH and such kind of moiety will takes place, and this increase in the number of coordination number of metal, this facilitates the decomposition of this complex, and then the formation of MH and such type of complex, this such type of compound will takes place, and this is due to beta hydride elimination in organometallic compound. These are transition metal alkyls. Beta hydride elimination occurs in transition metal alkyls that have beta hydrogen, and transfer of beta hydrogen takes place to the metal. So the beta hydrogen will transfer to the metal during beta hydride elimination, and it occurs in the transition metal alkyls that have beta hydrogen. So if there is no beta hydrogen, then no beta hydride elimination will take place. The second kind of pathway that decomposes the metal alkyls is intramolecular reductive elimination. So this reductive elimination, generally it occurs immediately after oxidative addition. So what do you mean by reductive elimination? So reductive means the decrease in the oxidation state of metal. So in these kind of reactions, oxidation state of metal decreases as well as the coordination number will also decrease. So coordination number decreases to elements or groups, they eliminated. This is reductive elimination reaction, and this is one of the step in the homogeneous catalytic processes, where immediately after oxidative addition reactions, this reductive elimination takes place. So it occurs within a molecule. So such kind of, this is an example, PTHR. Here you can see that this complex formed is RH. So a reductive elimination takes place. Generally it takes place during catalytic process, and this is also a decomposition pathway of organometallic hydrides. So organometallic hydrides, because they are formed during oxidative addition reactions, so reductive elimination occurs generally for organometallic hydrides. The other decomposition pathway is homolytic fission of MC bond. So sometimes this kind of organometallic compounds, this is organometallic compound, alkyl compound, and in this case sometimes homolytic fission can takes place of MC bond, and thus they can easily decompose, and these are very unstable organometallic compounds. So we can conclude that the transition metal alkyls are very reactive, and they are very unstable, and their instability or unstability or reactivity is due to three processes. One is hydride elimination. That hydride elimination may be alpha or beta. The organometallic compounds having alpha hydrogen or beta hydrogen, they may decompose through that pathway. The second pathway is intramolecular reductive elimination. Intramolecular reductive elimination means this occurs during catalytic processes where oxidative addition takes place. So it generally occurs in metal hydride complexes and occur immediately after oxidative addition reactions. And third one is homolytic fission of MC bond. Sometimes in some organometallic compounds, this kind of homolytic fission occurs, and they become very unstable type of organometallic compounds. Now the question arises that how could we stabilize transition metal alkyls, because there are a number of decomposition pathways, and it is very difficult to synthesize transition metal alkyls in under such conditions. So it is necessary to prepare some transition metal alkyls that are stable. So how can we stabilize the transition metal alkyls? In this title, I will give you the answer how we can make the transition metal alkyl stable. So what we have to do? We have to suppress the decomposition pathways. So if in any way, if we suppress the decomposition pathways of transition metal alkyls, they become stabilized because they have some decomposition pathways. So if we break that decomposition pathways, and thus we can get the stabilized transition metal alkyls. So what are those suppression reactions or suppression ways that can suppress the decomposition pathways? So number one point is formation of sterically and energetically unfavorable organometallic compounds. So we can decrease, we can suppress the decomposition pathways by formation of sterically and energetically unfavorable organometallic compounds. So the example is this. This is a norbornyl ligand. This norbornyl ligand, and here at the bridging position, the metal is attached. So if we prepare such kind of complex, then it is very difficult to decompose such kind of complex because this double bond is energetically unfavorable. Because this double bond is present in the carbon atom which is bridged. So this cannot occur. So we can form such kind of organometallic compounds in which metal is present at the bridge position, and this is a non-rigid type of ligand. So this will break the decomposition pathway of this compound. Again, there is an example, another example. You can see that this is the beta hydrogen. So this beta hydrogen can be eliminated. But by synthesizing such type of compound where the product is sterically or energetically unfavorable because it is a benzyne. Yeah, here there is a triple bond, and you know that benzyne is very unstable compound. So we can prepare such type of compounds where beta hydrogen, even in the presence of beta hydrogen, the elimination or the decomposition pathway can be suppressed. Like in the previous case, you can see that these hydrogens are beta hydrogens. So any beta hydrogen can be eliminated. But due to its rigid property, this elimination has been suppressed. So we can synthesize such kind of molecules where the products are unfavorable energetically as well as sterically. The other suppression method is absence of beta hydrogen in organic ligand. So if we remove beta hydrogen from the organic ligand, then there may be no beta elimination. So the compound becomes stable. The third method to suppress the decomposition pathway of transition metal alkyl is that the central metal atom can be made quantitatively saturated. It means the compound is quantitatively unsaturated when the valence electrons are not equal to 18. So in this case, TiMe4 is a quantitatively unsaturated compound, and the compound can be made quantitatively saturated by converting it into such kind of compound, and this compound is a stable compound. So this can easily decompose by alpha elimination, but by formation of this kind of complex, the stability of the complex can be increased. Then free coordination sites of this kind of compounds, TiMe4, can be blocked, then it become more stable. So because it is coordinatively unsaturated, so there is vacant site on Ti. So if we block this vacant site on Ti, then the complex will be more stable. So either we can made it coordinatively saturated, or we can block its vacant site and form such kind of complex, so that we can see that we have included one more ligand, so that its coordination number increases and it will become coordinatively saturated compound. So this compound is more stable as compared to this pure metal alkyl complex. So in gist or in conclusion, we can say that the transition metal alkyls are very unstable species, and these species can be stabilized by suppression of their decomposition pathway. So there are several methods by which we can suppress their decomposition pathway. So one of these is we can form energetically unfavorable organometallic compound, and second one is we can make these unsaturated, coordinatively unsaturated compound coordinatively saturated, or we can block the vacant side of these organometallic alkyls, And one more method is that we eliminate the beta hydrogen from the ligand, with which the transition metal complexes is forming transition metal alkyl. So in these ways, we can suppress the decomposition pathway and make the transition metal alkyls stable.